Hey, what is going on, guys? It is Spoory Dan here, back again with another Rocket League car designs. And in this episode, I finally got the black market decal, Interstellar. As most of you guys know, I have been wanting this decal ever since it came out, but obviously I had to wait for the price to go down. But I finally picked it up for only 2,700 credits, which isn't that bad. So yeah, if you guys have not hit the subscribe button, make sure to hit the subscribe button down below to get up to date on my newest Rocket League car design videos. So let's get started with the first car designs. Now, I have a lot of different car designs ready for you guys, so a little bit longer of an episode, but a lot of amazing designs. So starting off, we have the pink octane for the orange side, and then for the blue side, we do have the lime octane. For the decal, it is obviously the black market decal Interstellar, and then for the colors, we have a dark forest green as the primary, and then the accent as a light green. And then for the orange side, we have a dark purple or dark pink with the accent as a light red, actually, or a light pink in a way. For the wheels, for the blue or for the orange side, we have the pink Vedeva wheels too. And then for the blue side, we do have the Vedeva wheels painted lime for the blue side. Now, the reason why I chose this wheels is because I really thought it matched that Interstellar a lot. And then the reason why I chose the colors, I know it's lime, but I really like doing the dark colors for the primary when I do lime, because it really makes the car as well as the wheels pop a little bit more. And then I chose the light lime green as the accent. And then same for this side, I chose that dark pink with the lighter pink at the accent, because it really makes the car and the wheels stand out as well. Now, this decal reminds me a little bit of Title Stream, not as much though, but the accent really doesn't change sometimes, like the sky pink. It depends what color you really choose it on, but it reminds me a little bit of Title Stream, but obviously it is my favorite decal, being such a huge space fan. And yeah, so getting on to the boost, we do have the Shining Barrage 2 unpainted for the orange side, and then for the blue side, we do have the Lime Shining Barrage 2. Now, the reason why I chose this boost is because it really has that dark and lime, as well as this side. We have all the colors. We have the purple, the pink, everything like that. So, yeah. No topper, no antenna, no goal explosion. But for the trail, we have the pink Rad Rocks. Now, the reason why I only have pink Rad Rock as well. But Rad Rock also matches that, like, theme a little bit, the Interstellar theme. And then for the lime side, we do not have lime Rad Rock, but we do have lime Hollow Data. So, I chose lime Hollow Data for the trail as the blue side. So this is the blue side. Like I said, I really like choosing the darker primaries for when I use a lime color, because it really makes the car as well as the wheels stand out. And same for this side. The dark pink really match with the Vedeva wheels, and it's got that whole like same like design and everything like that. So it looks really good, and the color combination is really nice for both sides. Getting into the next car design, we do have the sky blue and the burnt sienna. Now, I know it's not as much burnt sienna, but burnt sienna looks amazing on this Interstellar. I'm going to say that right now. It's got that red tint to it and everything. So starting off, we have the orange or the burnt sienna octane for the orange side. And then for the blue side, we have the sky blue octane. Now, decal Interstellar. For the colors, we have a sky blue for the primary, and then the accent as a dark purple. And you'll see why I chose dark purple especially for this one, for the accent. And then for the side, we have a burnt sienna, and then the accent as even a darker burnt sienna. Now, it's got that whole red feeling. This is one of, like, burnt sienna looks really good because it's got that red tint to it and everything. But for the wheels, we have the Muscle Boys burnt sienna for the orange side, and then the sky blue Muscle Boys for the blue side. Now, the reason why I chose Muscle Boys is because this sky blue matches the Muscle Boys the best, the primary. That's why I chose the Muscle Boys especially. And same for this side, that burnt sienna and that darker burnt sienna looks really good with the Muscle Boys. And then the reason why I chose the colors is for the boost on this side, because this one is a sky blue neothermal. As you can see, it's got that same sky blue color as well as that really dark purple in the back. So that is why I chose the sky blue and the accent as purple. And then for the boost for the brown side, we do have a Glimmer Slang burnt sienna. Glimmer Slang also matches it really nicely, getting that whole burnt sienna as well as the lighter color. No topper, no antenna, no goal explosion. But for the trail, we do have the burnt sienna Hacksworth 3. And then for the blue side, we do have the sky blue Hacksworth 3. Now, you can usually use any trail, but I just really like Hacksworth because it's nice and clean as well. So So this is the blue side. Like I said, I chose the colors, the sky blue and the dark purple at the top because of my boost. But the sky blue just looks also incredible in Interstellar. And it just looks really, really good. And same with this side. The burnt sienna has that red tint to it, looking really nicely. And it just looks amazing. Getting into the next car design, we do have the Hypnotics, my favorite color combination of this whole entire episode. So starting off, we have a cobalt octane for the blue side. And then unfortunately, I do not have a crimson octane or a tea white, but a crimson or a tea white will look incredible with this. And the color combination also really makes it look dark, matching the black Hypnotics. But for the decal, it's Interstellar. But for the colors, we have a cobalt as the primary. And then the accent as a purple, looking like the Milky Way. And then for the primary, for the orange side, we do have a very, very dark red with the accent as black. Trying to get it as dark as possible to match the black Hypnotics. But even if I do go as dark as possible with the color, it's still got that white color that goes throughout the Interstellar car, looking really nicely. I'm sorry, I can't get over how beautiful this decal looks. One of the best decals in the game, in my opinion. For the wheels, we have the black Hypnotics for the orange side. And then for the blue side, we do have the normal Hypnotics, making a great color combination on the car with that dark purple as well as the lighter purple at the accent. For the boost, for the blue side, we do have the cobalt radiant gush. And then for the orange side, we have the black radiant gush. Now you can either use black radiant gush or you can use titanium white, whichever one you like best. I rather have black to keep the car as clean as possible or as dark as possible as well. But no topper, no antenna, no gold explosion. But for the trail, we do have the black rad rock trail for the orange side. And then for the blue side, we do have the cobalt rad rock trail. So this is the blue side. This is my favorite color combination. It looks really, really clean with the darker purple and the accent as purple. And then for this side, trying to make the car as dark as possible. But even that Interstellar, like that red goes through it. Even if it's dark as possible, it's still got that light red going through it. And it looks really, really good. Getting into the next car design, we do have a orange and a dark purple. So starting off, we have a orange octane for the orange side. And then for the blue side, we do have a purple octane. Now, this is another great color combination right here, a darker purple and a lighter purple. So for the colors, we do have a dark purple with a lighter purple. And then for the orange side, we have a orange with the accent as a orange yet again. I don't know why, but if you just look at it, that Interstellar flows through the car and it gives that red tint to it and everything. It just looks really, really good. But for the wheels, we do have these Capacitator 1 wheels. Now, this is giving off that same color. I think these wheels are glitched a little bit as well because, you know, I don't know why. They just look a little bit different. But yeah, we got the Capacitator wheels. And then for the orange side, we have the orange Capacitator wheels, that bright orange and that white, or that a little bit of a darker orange. Like I said, I think they're glitched because I don't remember ever them being this bright. But yeah, the reason why I chose the colors is because this color combination is amazing. Like that dark purple with the lighter purple. And then for this side, the oranges look really good. And it's got that red tint going through it, looking really, really nice. For the boost, we do have a orange slash beam 3 for the orange side. And then for the blue side, we do have a purple slash beam. Now, I thought slash beam was very fitting for this one with the purple and then the dark, like, black dark purple area. And then for this side, we have the orange as well as the darker orange as well. I just thought it was really fitting for this one. So yeah, no topper, no antenna, no gold explosion. But for the trail, we do have orange tachyon 3 for the orange side. And then for the blue side, we do have purple laser wave 3. So this is the purple side, a great color combination, looking really nicely with the purple octane as well. Remember, you guys do not need painted octanes, but it just looks really good as well as the color combination. And then same for this side, the two oranges, and then you have that red flowing through the car with the Interstellar. So yeah. Getting into the last and final car design of the episode, we do have another pink as well as a forest green. So for the blue side, we do have the forest green octane. And then for the blue side, we do have a, or for the orange side, we have a pink octane. For the colors, we do have a forest green for the primary. And then the accent as black. And then for the orange side, we do have a pink with the accent as a lighter pink. Now, the celestial wheels I had to use because obviously they're star themed as well, so I had to fit them in this design. So for the pink side, we do have the Celestial 2 painted pink. And then for the blue side, we do have the forest green Celestial 2s. So obviously the reason why I chose the black as the accent is because I wanted it as dark as possible because it matches the Celestial wheels. But for this side, I actually wanted it a little bit lighter of a design instead of black, because I really didn't think black looked as good with this one. So I wanted the lighter pink to make that car pop a little bit more. For the boost, we do have the Rad Rock painted pink for the orange side. And then for the blue side, we do have the forest green Rad Rock. I think Rad Rock really fits this one, especially because it's got that really dark as well as the rock type thing. So I think this one matches the best. And then no topper, no antenna, no goal explosion. But for the trail, we have forest green Laser Wave 3. And then for the pink side, we do have Rad Rock painted pink. I finally have a pink trail, so, you know, you'll be seeing a lot more pink Rad Rock instead of classic. But, so this is the blue side. This side is my favorite. The forest green with the Interstellar looks really clean. So this is the blue side. And then this is the orange side with the pink and the light pink at top. So, yeah. Obviously, this is one of my favorite decals of all time. Like, better than Dissolver, and that's a lot to say. So I will be rocking this decal all the time. But I hope you guys enjoyed the video. Make sure to leave a like and subscribe for more. I'll see you guys in the next episode.